Hey Ross World, my money makes money. It's not a question if you want life insurance. It's a statement that you need life insurance. Now take for instance, I'm up there riding my bike. Maybe I didn't snap up my bike helmet, or maybe I did, but I get into a car accident and I die. Or I fall off and I die. I'm not planning for that death. So it's not a question if you want life insurance. It's a statement that you need life insurance. Now there's two types of life insurance, okay? You have permanent life insurance, also whole life insurance, the same thing. Then you have term life insurance, okay? Now your permanent life insurance is quite pricey in comparison to your term life insurance. Perm life insurance covers you for your entire life. The perks for that is it actually has cash value, and also many of the good accounts. I'm gonna give you four companies I believe that will treat you and do you well. Now, unfortunately, term life insurance doesn't have cash value. It doesn't pay you dividends. Perm life insurance pay you dividends. Now, say for instance, you had a policy that covered you for $50,000 and you received 3% dividends. At the end of the year, that account would have paid you $1,500. Now, a lot of these have the option for your dividends to pay off your premiums, which is a great thing. So in a sense, it almost pays for itself depending on the amount. I don't know too many people who's going to get a policy only for $50,000, but that's a good example so you understand that it's still going to pay you money. Now, a lot of these are what they call cash value, meaning you don't have to pay off your premium with it. You can actually have that money deposited into your account and you can use it for whatever you want. Some people use those dividends to keep their business running after their death and they sign it to one of their heirs. Now, hair or her, H-E-I-R, I messed it up. But the point I'm making here, that permanent life insurance has cash value and also pays dividends. Unfortunately, term life insurance is a lot cheaper, and it doesn't have those same options, but it's still going to give you that policy. And also perm life insurance have what they call guaranteed death benefit. That means the amount that your policy is the amount they're going to pay you. Now, term life insurance is good, especially when you're in your midlife, okay? When you're in your midlife, you have all these other expenses, you can't total up $1,500 a year, or you can't total up $500 a month. These are really expensive. Some range from $250 to $1,000, depending on the amount that your policy covers. Now, term life insurance could be 10, 20, 30 years, or a certain age, maybe 60, 70, or 80. Perm life insurance covers you for your entire life. I understand this is somewhat of a morbid conversation and no one really likes to talk about it, but guess what? Guess what? Everybody dies. Everybody dies. I'm going to die. My family's going to die. Your family's going to die. And nobody wants to talk about death, just like nobody wants to talk about money. But this is the thing, we're all going to die. And it's not no fun talking about it, but the point is, you want to set yourself up and your family and your loved ones or maybe your business for success. Because what is life insurance really for? What is it really for? Perm life insurance can actually help you pay for some of your death expenses. But most importantly, any life insurance is to help fill the void, fill the gap, supplement that paycheck, that money, that revenue that you had coming in. Now, life insurance is the plug. It's the plug to help your family to move on. Yeah, they're going to grieve. They're going to cry, all those things. But guess what they're going to need, too? That you were providing your financial income. Life insurance is the plug. But you're probably thinking, well, you know, I got savings. I got investments. But why not have a little bit more? Once again, if you get perm life insurance, you get those dividends back. You can actually get paid while you're still alive. And guess another thing about perm life insurance with that cash value. The money that you'll be accumulating, the money that you'll be adding to your bank account or reinvesting to pay off your premium, is actually tax deferred. What does that mean? That means that it's not taxable. It's not taxable. And you can actually borrow from it. You can borrow from the cash value of your perm life insurance and it's not taxable. So look at that option as well. But let's get back on it. You need life insurance because you never know when you're going to go. Again, You need life insurance because you never know when you are going to go. You have to help those loved ones to move on financially. It's no longer about you. You have to set those guys up, okay? I have life insurance. I have my wife on it. She gets everything, okay? But you need life insurance. Now, the average life insurance, it's about $500 to $1,500 a year. So that's roughly $40 to $150 a month, depending on your coverage, okay? That would dictate your premium. That would dictate your monthly amount. Now, there's one more thing to know. There are five main categories that these life insurance companies actually dictates to see where your premium is going to be. The first one is age. The younger you are, the cheaper it is. Now, as you get older in age, the more drastically that amount changes. They also factor in gender because women have a longer life expectancy. Men prices are higher than women. Now, here's the main one, in my opinion, health. Your overall health, because we know some of you guys don't get off the couch, you don't go work out. And I'm not saying go to a gym, I just do 400 push-ups sometimes a day. You have to work your body in some sort of way. I got my little watch here, I do my little steps, count your steps, do something. Some of you guys don't need life insurance, some of you guys need life protection, because you're just fat as hell, okay? Just be real with yourself. Just look in the mirror, like, you may be happy with yourself, but you're fat. You need to go do something. Even me, I'm still trying to lose weight months later. The other one is your job. Your job, depending on what your job is. If you're a guy who works in an office business, you're behind a desk, you're at a computer, yours tend to be lower than someone who probably works construction. That also increases the amount of your premium. Then last but not least is your hometown, your state. Take for somebody in Alaska, their premiums are higher than someone living in Montana. Maybe because you live in a dangerous territory, maybe there's a lot of wildlife, I don't know. But these are the five major factors that these life insurance companies come up with in order to charge you this monthly or yearly fee. So that's basically it when it comes to life insurance. So here are my top four life insurance companies that I've done some research on, and they are phenomenal. They're spectacular. Okay, so listen up, and I will have their links. I remember my viewer told me, I will have their links in the description. Thanks for the advice. The first one is Northwestern Mutual. Second, Mass Mutual. Guardian Life. So that's Northwestern Mutual, Mass Mutual, Guardian Life, and State Farm Life. So those are my top four. Do your own research. Get into the details. This is about your life and the ones that you are taking care of. So remember what I said earlier in the video. This can actually help your business to keep going with that cash value. You have to get into the details in each company, how you can actually take money out or have that money to be applied to your business. So generation after you will still have ownership of whatever you started. This is Ross World. My money makes money, whether I'm dead or alive. Please take care of your families. I'm out.